The Cost Optimizer for Amazon Workspaces analyzes all of your Amazon Workspace usage data and automatically converts the workspace to the most cost-effective billing option depending on your individual usage. You can use this AWS solution with a single account or with AWS organizations across multiple accounts. We're pleased to announce the Cost Optimizer for Amazon Workspaces version 2.7, which includes numerous enhancements implemented based on direct customer feedback. In this video, we'll demonstrate how to deploy the Cost Optimizer for Amazon Workspaces, how to use CloudWatch dashboards for insights, how to review daily summaries, identifying user sessions, and we'll talk about the next steps when deploying the solution. To get started, here's Dave Jasky, an EUC Specialist Solutions Architect with AWS, to guide you through the deployment steps.
Thanks, Rob. First, we'll navigate to the Workspaces Cost Optimizer solution. This page contains detailed information on the architecture, implementation, as well as other steps for deployment. Right side, you can view the CloudFormation template, as well as the implementation guide. The implementation guide covers several deployment scenarios for the Workspaces Cost Optimizer. After reviewing the implementation guide, click on the CloudFormation template. For this scenario, we'll do a hub account setup. Click on the View template, and that will download the template for the next step when we go back into the AWS console. Now return to the AWS console. We'll choose an existing template and select Upload Template File, and we'll use the file that was just downloaded in the previous step. For the parameters, start by entering a stack name. For this deployment, we'll keep it simple and deploy to a new VPC. For additional options, please review the admin guide. For the VPC settings, we'll leave everything at the default and scroll down to the testing parameters. For this deployment, we'll launch in dry run mode. This will not make any changes to the workspace. In addition, we'll simulate the end of the month cleanup in here as well. As we scroll through the pricing parameters, we'll leave this at the defaults as well. For additional information, see the Workspaces pricing. For the AWS regions, we'll leave this blank to get all the regions where Workspaces are deployed. In addition, we'll not do terminations. Finally, we'll do a single account deployment. At the next screen, we'll review information for the CloudFormation template. Finally, we'll review the parameters that we've set up for the CloudFormation template. At the bottom, we'll click Acknowledge, and then click Submit. The CloudFormation is now deploying into your account. You can click the Refresh button to watch the events for the CloudFormation template deployment. Please wait till this is complete before going to the next steps. Now that you have the Cost Optimizer deployed, we'll take a look at the CloudWatch dashboard that was generated. If you just recently deployed the Cost Optimizer, the Event Bridge rule needs to run once before the data becomes available. By default, this is once per day, and you can view the details in Amazon EventBridge. Switching back to the console, we can see the workspaces that are deployed, in this case 31 between a few different regions in my account. We can see the different hourly versus monthly billing. As we scroll down, we can see some additional historical information as well. As this runs, we'll get additional information that will populate in this dashboard as well. In addition to the CloudWatch dashboards, you will get daily reports on the workspaces. We'll show you here how you can take a look at the data and make decisions on Workspaces running mode, compute, and volumes that you have deployed to your users. In the S3 console, we'll first select the year, then we'll select the month, and then the date that we're looking for the report. This will show a detailed report for each directory, as well as an aggregation report for all the workspaces that are deployed. For this, we'll click on the aggregated dry run end of the month report. At the next window, we'll click Download, and this will download a copy of the report to my desktop. When the workspace report is open, there'll be a column for the change reported. This column is for showing the workspace that should be changed between always on or hourly. The next column has information on the bundle type, as well as the initial mode for the start of the month, as well as the mode for the next month. As we move down, each of the columns will have additional information on that workspace's instance. Further down, we have information on the CPU usage, the memory usage, as well as the volume usage within that workspace. Using this information, you can make decisions on increasing the compute type to provide a better experience or decreasing for cost savings. In addition, details are provided on the volumes for planning increases to the workspace's instances. Finally, there's information that's captured on the average packet loss as well as in-session latency for planning additional regions. We just showed you how you can take a look at the aggregated data for a specific workspace. If you're looking to dive deeper into a specific user session, that data is available as well. This may be useful to dive into a user that may be reporting an issue. With the Cost Optimizer, you have detailed information on that specific user session with the average latency, packet loss, CPU, memory, as well as volume information. To get detailed information on the sessions, go to the AWS console and go to the DynamoDB service, and then click on the User Sessions table. Once it loads, we'll click on the Explore Table Items, and this will give us a row for each of the individual sessions that have been signed into WorkSpaces. For each of the sessions that we have out there, we'll have information on the start time, the end time, along with all the detailed metrics for that individual session. This includes CPU, memory, in-session latency, UDP packet loss, along with information on the root and user volume. Using this data will help you get quick insight into a user session, as well as any factors that may have been causing a poor experience.